She was one of the fastest people in the world, once dubbed the fastest woman on ice. She has broken 13 world speed skating records. Katrina LeMay-Doan is the Wayne Gretzky of speed skating. You'll recall being wowed by her in Nagano and Salt Lake City in 1998 and 2002 with outstanding medal performances, two gold and a bronze combined in both of those games. Katrina has been in Halifax touring the long track oval for the Canada Winter Games, which is being presented in part by CTV Atlantic, and she's taking a few minutes to join us here tonight. We're glad to have you. It's nice to see you again.
I'm glad to be here.
So what do you think of this outdoor oval in Halifax?
Finally, I've seen it.
Yeah.
I've heard about it for the last few years, and we were there this afternoon and seeing it under construction. I'm excited. I'm excited for my sport of speed skating. I'm excited for the athletes, but I'm excited for this community as well, because this isn't just for the sport, it's for everybody.
Did they ask for advice on design and construction while you were there? Did you offer any?
That's not my specialty.
No, okay.
I know how to skate. Well, yeah. I did know how to skate. But what we did discuss, and Chris Morrissey from the 2011 Canada Games, we've known each other for a few years. I've heard about this project. And some of the guys who make the ice in Calgary at the Oval are going to be coming here in a couple of months and helping to make the ice.
This is an outdoor oval.
Yeah.
Now, what's that like for a skater, being outdoors?
I want people to understand that to be inside is rare. The only covered speed skating oval in Canada is in Calgary. Many of the World Cups are still outdoors. Most of us grew up doing short track when it wasn't cold enough for long track ice, and then going outdoors. Mm. But to have an outdoor artificially refrigerated oval, this is rare. And the first time it's ever happened in Atlantic Canada.
When you are in a place like this, though, where the winters can be, shall we say, rainy and foggy, as opposed to snowy and cold, some people wonder if it isn't a bit chancy to build this outdoors. Is it chancy?
It would be if it was natural ice.
Yeah.
But the fact that it's refrigerated, you can control the temperature. And so you're going to still be dealing with a bit of wind and whether there's some rain and some snow. Mm. You're going to deal with those outdoor elements. But the athletes are used to that. The great thing is that you'll be able to control temperature. So if it wasn't going to be cold enough to deal with a natural ice, this way there will be long track. I did my last Winter Canada Games in 87. It's the last time that Nova Scotia hosted the Games.
In Sydney.
Yeah, but there was no long track ice. So I did short track. So this, for the athletes, knowing that there's long track speed skating is very exciting.
It may be the spectators who have to get used to the weather then. The athletes will be okay.
Well, spectators can bundle up.
Yeah,
I mean,
that's
they
right.
don't have to wear the spandex suits.
That's right. We can put on the slickers and the funny
hats. Yeah, exactly. It'll be great.
Let's talk about, you had, beyond your Olympic experience, you had a lot of Canada Games experience, winter and summer. But talk about Sydney in 1987. What do you remember about Sydney in 1987?
That was my second Winter Games. My first ones were in 83. I was 12. So to come to these second ones when I was 16, that was when I knew I wanted to go to the Olympics. This was a stepping stone for me. And I remember being in the rink. I mean, it was so long ago, but I remember being there talking with my friends and realizing my race was coming up and going out. And this is the highest level of competition in Canada. And I never won a gold at those games. I won a silver and a bronze.
I was going to ask.
I wanted to. I didn't. But, you know, it was an experience that I took with me forever. And these athletes that will be here competing, truly the best in Canada in every sport. Mm. And for many of them, this is a stepping stone to the Olympics.
Yeah, many get to the Olympics, as you
About three quarters of the Olympians, 2010 Olympians, about three quarters were Canada Games alumni. That's how important this is in the athletes' journey.
You did three Canada Games.
Yes. So two.
Sydney.
Yes. Chicoutimi in 83.
Right.
Cape Breton, so my medal say, in 87. And then I actually did a summer. I did Kamloops in 93. I did athletics.
And how'd you do?
I made some finals. I did heptathlon and hurdles in the relays. And I was eight. I was happy with that. It was a dream of mine to do a summer sport at that level. And I qualified for Team Saskatchewan. And so, it was, again, great memories.
How do you feel when people say, as I'm about to, that if speed skating has gain prominence in the country, that you're significantly responsible for that? Are you willing to wear that?
I'm one of. You know, it's an honor. It's also a responsibility. And that's what I remind athletes. When you go out onto the, whether it's the Canadian stage or on the world stage, you're so proud to represent your province or territory or your country. But with that, there's also responsibility. Mm. And, you know, I respect that. And I love the fact that You know, you go places and people get excited, whether it's kids or adults. And, you know, that's the great thing about Canada Games is it's not distant from everybody. And with the long track speed skating, people are going to be able to watch this sport for free. The most successful winter sport in the Olympics since 1994. They'll be able to be part of it.
You got to be part of the Olympics, the torch bearing, in the famous, shall we say, torch malfunction.
Yes.
Now, we watched it. We were all sort of sitting here bleeding for you. What did that feel like for you?
You know, it's one of those situations. We did three middle of the night rehearsals,
and
until the first rehearsal, of course.
It's Murphy's Law, Katrina. You know,
yes, yes. But until that first rehearsal, we didn't know who the other torchbearers were, and so that's when we found out.
They were all superstars, by the way, and none of you knew who the others were.
No. And so it was exciting, but then when that happened, we had an earpiece in, we were hearing what was happening, and my heart dropped. So as soon as they told me to turn around and you were going to just sort of honor the IOC, my first thought was I should go to Steve Nash's cauldron. And I thought, no, that's his cauldron. It was 3 days before the closing ceremonies. The producer phoned me, and he had this idea of having me a part of that. And so in the end, it worked out really well, but it was stressful.
Yeah, and it was a wonderful event, Vancouver, the Vancouver Games. You were involved in the Vancouver Games.
I was part of the bid team originally in 2003, and then I was on the board, and then to be part of the broadcast team. And so what's great about these Canada Games that are coming up in February of 2011, everybody's still excited from the games, from Vancouver. Yeah. And for Canadians, this will be wonderful.
When was the last time you had a pair of blades on?
I go on it quite a bit. Not necessarily in the crouch speed skating position, but when I go skating with my kids, I only have speed skates. I don't have hockey skates. Yeah. So somebody mentioned today about bringing my speed skates out here when the ice is going.
You're
going
to do it?
Well, I hope so. I'll be here broadcasting, and so it's going to be busy, but I hope to get out onto the oval and do a bit of skating.
And about your kids, do they skate?
They do skate. My six-year-old daughter, she is skating. She's playing ringette. She skated since she was about three, and my three-year-old son has been skating since he was one. He's quite a stubborn little boy.
And he's got you on one side of the family tree and Shane Doan on the other, because Shane Doan is your husband's cousin.
First cousin, yes. Yeah. And Bart, my husband, played hockey as well. So.
And he's an oval maker.
He knows how to make ice. And so part
your
of that
team your kids haven't got
here.
A prayer. They're going to be all over ice. Yeah, it's great. Listen, it's wonderful you've come in. You're going to have a big birthday, by the way, coming up, your next birthday.
Thanks for reminding me.
No, how do you feel about that?
You know, I've always been excited to turn 30. Oh, maybe
this is 30
decade.
Plus HST shipping handling.
Yeah. It's, I'm a Christmas baby, but you know what? I've always sort of said, well, enjoy every year, and every year sort of is different. And so the kids keep reminding me, but thank you for reminding me as well. My 40th. Great.
Well, you've just said it. People at home are assuming you're turning 30 or 25 again.
Of course.
It's wonderful of you to come. We'll look forward to seeing you in Halifax during the 2011 games.
Thank you.
And again, CTV Atlantic, very pleased to be a major sponsor of this event, something we're all looking forward to. And we'll be back with more in just a moment. Thanks. Thank you.